At Capital Land Motors, we're overloaded with 2015 Subaru Foresters. There's 50 in stock and 20 on the way. Step into a new 2015 Subaru Forester starting as low as $21,950. $21,950. Get your Forester only at Capital Land Motors, Route 50 across from the airport, Glenville.
Tonight, catch a special episode of The Big Bang Theory and a hilarious new Mike and Molly, followed by NCIS Los Angeles and Scorpion. Then stay tuned for CBS 6 News at 11. Tonight's lineup brought to you by the New York State Smokers Quit Line.
I've got pests.
Is something keeping you up at night? Squirrels can be quite a nuisance, wreaking havoc in your attic. Cat's Eye will eliminate the critters, disinfect all nesting areas, and seal off the entry points. For a job done right so you can sleep easy, schedule your inspection at catseyepest.com. What's in your
attic?
All
the best of the best to get rid of your pests.
Cat's Eye Pest Control. This is CBS 6 News.
A weather alert tonight. Steve says we're down to flurries in most places now as today's snowmaker moves away. More cold air is coming in, though. When you can expect it to hit your neighborhood?
And a study said Albany had one of the least diverse police forces in the country, but have they improved? Good evening. I'm Greg Floyd.
And I'm Jennifer Mullen. The snow done falling tonight, but Steve says the cold air isn't far behind.
Snow covering just about everything you saw today. This is a look at Rexford, the street, homes and trees all blanketed in white. Very little action on this block, with most folks apparently at work or staying warm indoors.
Can you blame them? Downtown Albany feeling the effects of today's snowfall. Several people using the umbrella or trying to stay warm inside the CDTA bus stops.
And how about this? The snow falling in Niskayuna earlier today. It was painting this pretty picture. That does look like a nice picture. Snow covering the wooden fence along Rosendale Road. The trees in the background getting a nice coating as well. Our chief meteorologist, Steve LaPointe, is up now with a look at what to expect this evening. No more snow, right, Steve?
Yeah, pretty much done. Instant Doppler 6 is bearing that out. In fact, even in the last 10 minutes, what radar returns we had have pretty much disappeared. There are some very light flakes falling from the low cloud deck, but nothing that's going to amount to that much. And temperatures are at or slightly above freezing. In fact, sitting at 33 at Albany, so we remain moderate. And there won't be a lot of change, at least through the evening hours. The cold's going to come in late tonight, though. After midnight, we'll see the true Arctic front going by. So by or shortly after daybreak, I think we will have plunged all the way to around 8 degrees as skies clear out. And that's going to lead to a lot of sunshine tomorrow, but daytime temperatures will not recover all that much, expecting afternoon highs right around 12 or 13. Plenty of sun, frigid conditions, but not much wind. So that's the break we'll be getting versus the cold that came in last week.
All right, thank you, Steve. When the snow starts falling, don't forget you can stay ahead of the storm with the CBS 6 weather app. It's complete with all sorts of forecasts and radar. Download it now. Just search WRGBWX on your Apple or Android device.
CBS 6 continues to follow developing news out of Guilderland tonight. Police arresting a woman following a road rage incident involving a school bus full of students. Investigators tell CBS 6 Beth Aviza intentionally cut the Mohannessen school bus off on Ryan Place in Guilderland this morning, causing the bus to stop suddenly. They say she then got out of her car and tried to pry the door of the bus open, damaging it. The school district says she never got inside the bus. The bus driver says he thinks Aviza thought she was cut off, sparking all of this. Luckily, no one on the bus was hurt. Parents were all notified by the school. The kids were then transferred to another bus and taken to school. We're going to continue to look into this story for you, and we'll bring you more information tonight on CBS 6 News at 10 and 11.
The New York City Police Inspector General's office releasing its report now on the department's use of chokeholds. It does not include the death of Eric Garner. It found the review board that looks into chokehold cases did recommend punishing officers involved, but the department did not try to discipline officers in most of those cases. Instead, the report found that the officers were simply instructed on department policy. Chokeholds are banned by the department. The report focused on 10 suspected chokehold cases in the past 5 years. Well, Eric Garner's death in Staten Island raised a lot of concerns about police targeting African Americans. Many claim that law enforcement lacked diversity. Albany PD ranked the 8th least representative police department when it comes to race in the entire country. Kimberly Howard has a look at what it and other departments are doing to try to improve those numbers.
Find the type of men and women that you want to see on your police department and bring them to us.
Minority recruitment has been a priority since Albany Police Chief Stephen Krokoff became top cop in 2010, the same year the American Community Survey ranked the capital city as the eighth least representative police force in the nation.
I'm going to have more and more classes that are overrepresented as with people of color. To be able to fill that gap.
According to the most recent U.S. Census, Albany is roughly 30% African American, while the Albany Police Department is less than half that. Krokoff says that's actually an improvement from when the percentage of black officers hovered in the single digits. He credits the slight uptick to community recruitment, but the choke point, as Krokoff calls it, is the civil service exam.
I'm very interested to see if we can legally move to another form of entry exam and to see what result that may have.
Over in Troy, the police department is facing much of the same problem, with just over 5% of their police force either black or Hispanic, despite serving a city that's more than 16% black or Hispanic.
I think cultural differences sometimes take effect in law enforcement, and having people who they can relate to is important as far as the police force goes.
In Schenectady, nearly 8% of their police force is black or Hispanic, but the city, more than 30%.
They see these numbers and they're disheartened.
You're right. It is pretty low. You know, in terms of percentages over the last few academy classes, we've had some good success. In terms of the overall numbers, we're still lacking.
Recruiting efforts continue for all departments at local colleges and universities.
I think what we need to do is to reach out to younger individuals, not just at the college campus, because some of the things they may have already done in their life might preclude them from employment.
Police in Albany, Troy, and Schenectady agree that this topic being thrust into a national spotlight can only improve any racial disparity, although they admit there's still a long road ahead. Kimberly Howard, CBS 6 News.
Deadly drugs making their way through New York State, plus tax changes you need to know about that could affect your return. Those are just some of the other big stories we're following right now.
I'm Cody Holyoke. Following an alert in the nation's heroin epidemic, investigators in New York, New Jersey, and Pennsylvania are sending out a warning tonight surrounding three deadly brands of drugs being sold to look like heroin. New Jersey State Police call them by their street names Power Hour, Taliban, and Strike Dead. They contain potent and dangerous combinations of drugs not typically seen by law enforcement. Here at home, Albany County Sheriff Craig Apple tells me these compounds haven't yet surfaced in our area, but the news is troubling.
It's being sold more as a heroin product, but as far as we can tell, it's not an opiate-based product, and therefore the naloxone and Narcan doesn't have any effect on it. So if, in fact, you do have an overdose, the Narcan's not going to, it's not going to hurt the person. It just won't, it won't bring them back.
Many of the drug treatment centers around the capital region haven't yet heard of these specific drug combinations, but I'm told that new drugs and other toxic compounds being sold as drugs are something they see all too often. Cody Holyoke, CBS 6 News.
Jennifer Lukey, in Albany, tax season starts next Tuesday, which means if you haven't started getting your paperwork together, now is the time. Some of the new changes this year are in relation to Obamacare. If you signed up for a health care exchange, you may be able to claim a credit and get some cash back. If you didn't sign up and you don't have insurance, you'll have to pay a $95 penalty for the first time this year. Some of the most commonly missed deductions, education credits, out-of-pocket charitable contributions, and child care credits. So make sure you claim them if you're eligible. The State Department of Taxation and Finance is requiring all tax preparers be registered and trained this year. If you need help finding a reputable one, go to their website. Jennifer Lukey, CBS 6 News.
In France, the nation's still on alert tonight after last week's deadly terror attack. In a sign of unity over the weekend, millions gathered in the streets of France. Absent from that march, a high-ranking member of the Obama administration. This despite major world leaders like Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu taking part. White House officials admit they made a mistake.
And I think it's fair to say that we should have sent someone with a higher profile.
Secretary of State John Kerry will travel to France later this week. He made it very clear today the U.S. remains committed to helping France in any way it can.
Well, happening tonight, what's the future of Bishop McGinn High School in Albany? A task force has been looking at that school for several months now. Tonight, it will give its recommendations to the Diocesan School Board. There was talk last April of moving out of the current building, which is built for 1,200 students. A year ago, enrollment was at just 130 students. They have been considering a move to the old Cathedral School right down the block from the governor's mansion. And also happening tonight, Schenectady Mayor Gary McCarthy previewing his goals for 2015, his State of the City speech. speech scheduled for 7 o'clock at City Hall. It'll come ahead of tonight's City Council meeting.
I love this next one. An 80-year-old retired school principal cashing in his winning Mega Millions ticket today. $326 million, the biggest prize in New York lottery history. Harold Diamond, who lives in Sullivan County, says he bought the ticket for the November 4th drawing at a rest area. He says his wife insisted they pull over to wait out a storm on election day. Diamond says he's already looking forward to the next Mega Millions drawing tomorrow night.
It's $246 million. And I'm going to be online to buy another ticket. And I hope everybody in this room buys a ticket, because if it happened to us, it can happen to anybody. And like they say, you never know.
I love it. Diamond and his wife are taking home about $130 million after taxes. He says they plan to use the money to help family and give back to the local community. So it sounds like it ended up in the right hands.
Yeah, they seem like nice people. They really do. And this is a lesson to all those husbands out there. Your wife
is always right.
And if you believe that, you will be rich in many ways, right?
Yes, you will. Yeah. Very good.
And she's a former math teacher, so she knows what to do with the money.
If you were in the doghouse, you're out of it now, Greg.
There you go. For a few minutes at least.
At least. Yeah. A local 10-year-old legally blind and still kicking away from the competition.
The way his parents found out his vision was slowly fading away and how he's using it to become a role model now for his classmates.
I'm Dr. Andrew Morse from Kappa Region Orthopedics, and we're proud to recognize student athletes who give their personal best both on and off the field.
What's the point of having all that power? All that craftsmanship, all that technology, if you can't conquer this? What's the point of having a luxury sedan if you can't have it all the time? The all-weather drive Lexus IS, GS, and LS. Everything you'd expect from a Lexus, regardless of the weather. Lease the all-wheel drive 2015 IS 250 for $349 a month for 36 months. See your Lexus dealer.
Get a bigger mattress for less during the Metro Mattress King for a Queen sale. Right now, get this king for the same price as a queen, this queen for the same price as a full, this full for the same price as a twin. Remember, only Metro Mattress gives you a one-year sleep-on-it guarantee. Hurry in, the Metro Mattress King for a Queen sale ends soon.
You'll love your perfect mattress guaranteed. Metro Mattress.
Which way should we go?
This way.
But this side's golden, shiny, and fun. There's a chef making golden goose egg omelets.
Beautiful golden dancers.
Play the $7 million golden ticket and these other new scratch-off games at your New York Lottery retailer.
More date nights.
More late nights.
More laughs.
More naps.
At St. Peter's Health Partners, we do more for cancer care so our patients can get more out of life. We have the region's only Blue Distinction Center for the treatment of complex and rare cancers. And we offer advanced technologies in more locations. When it comes to cancer care, no one does more than St. Peter's Health Partners.
CBS 6 News with Steve LaPointe, the Weather Authority.
We are down to just some scattered flurries out there this evening. Accumulating snow is now long done. Next step with this will be the Arctic air that will be pouring in. But that won't happen until later tonight. So at least through the evening, early nighttime hours, it won't really be that cold with temperatures hovering near freezing. We're down to about 8, though, so a lot of cooling is going to take place between roughly midnight and 7 to 8 o'clock in the morning. In fact, I think we'll see this low around 8 to maybe 9 o'clock in the morning, so it'll be a case where even after the sun comes up, temperatures are probably just going to keep dropping as skies clear out. A lot of sunshine on your Tuesday. No real recovery, though, of substance during the afternoon in terms of temperature, about 13. There won't be a lot of wind, though, so it's a frigid day, but a frigid day without a lot of wind, and again, the sun does make a lot of difference, especially during the afternoon. Temperatures now upper 20s, Adirondacks to Lake George, Rutland sitting at 30, 32 at Saratoga with Schenectady at 34. These numbers actually pretty nice. It's the mildest we've been in the better part of a week. 33 Albany with Cobleskill sharing that temperature, Pittsfield 31, and Great Barrington now at 33 degrees. Again, we'll sit near these levels through the evening hours. One front going by with what's left of the light snow and flurries. The true Arctic front is back in here, so that's now pushing into the St. Lawrence River Valley, and it's north and west of that boundary that the temperatures really do start to plummet. In fact, even northwest of Montreal and Detroit, temperatures in the double-digit below zero territory up here across southeastern Canada. So another really cold air mass here, but not much wind with this as it comes into this time. So late tonight, tomorrow morning, that's when a piece of this will move into the northeast. Looks like another 24 to 36 hours stay for it. And then temperatures later in the week should once again start to come up again. But here's your temperature trend. Some flurries lingering through at least 10 o'clock. And then after that, even any leftover flakes of snow should be done. Frontal passage 11 to 12 o'clock, and temperatures will start to drop pretty sharply after that. So by about 7 in the morning, under mostly clear skies and fairly light wind, we're down to about 8. I think Indian Lake will be down to about 10 degrees below zero. Below zero for Wells, Queensbury about 5, and Gloversville 6. Glenville, Clifton Park expecting a low near 8 degrees. 8 for Troy, 8 for Pittsfield, 7 for Williamstown, Chatham, and Catskill dropping down to around 10 degrees. Now, I'm forecasting not that much wind. Northwest breeze anywhere from 5 to 15, but even that light wind, with temperatures in the Adirondacks dropping to between 10, 15 below towards morning, will be enough to produce wind chills between 20 and 25 below. So wind chill advisory, midnight to 10 o'clock in the morning, northern Herkimer and Hamilton counties. The rest of us, chills will be down near slightly below zero, but again, that will just be with a light breeze. So here are your afternoon numbers. Around 10 for Saratoga, 12 for Amsterdam and Oneonta, Kingston about 18, and Pittsfield tomorrow right around 15 degrees. We're below zero. Coming up Wednesday morning, it'll be a case, I think, in the northern mountains where it's 20, 25 below. Capital District closer to 2, 3 below, and about 22 for the high. So lots of bright skies on Wednesday. Thursday, just a tad less cold at 27, 30 on Friday with upper 20s Saturday, and then mid-30s Sunday. It's a weak front, I think, comes through that day, so just a slight chance of some mixed rain and snow showers. That will not be a major deal. No major storms coming up in the next 7 days, but certainly some major league cold by tomorrow and tomorrow night.
Looks like a good weekend to go snowboarding or skiing.
I guess, except
already
for that.
Already thinking ahead to next weekend, aren't you?
She knows how we operate here on the desk.
Does.
Yeah. All right. Thank you very much, Steve.
Yep.
Well, Crayola offering an apology tonight.
The social media mix-up that had some of its Facebook fans crying foul.
CBS 6 News is sponsored by the New York State Smokers Quit Line. For help quitting, talk to your doctor.
And I just wanted to say, GEICO is proud to have served the military for over 75 years.
Roger that. Cap is waiting to give you a tour of the Wisconsin now.
Could have parked a little bit closer. It's going to be dark by the time I get there.
GEICO, proudly serving the military for over 75 years.
Imagine if you had the power to protect your kids from cancer. You do. Get your kids, girls and boys, the HPV vaccine when they're 11 or 12, or as soon as possible if they're older. It will protect them from certain cancers and other diseases caused by HPV. So go on, use your powers to protect your kids. Talk to your child's doctor about the HPV vaccine today.
The World of Difference Institute has provided training and education in the Capital Region for 26 years. We've already trained thousands of students, teachers, and administrators from kindergarten through high school. With new laws to protect students, we can make an even bigger difference. Parents, you too can be an ally. Encourage your school to use these programs and stop bullying permanently. Imagine a world without hate.
Turn around.
Every now and then I get a little bit hungry and there's nothing really good around.
Turn around.
Every now and then I get a little bit tired of living off the taste of the air.
To the artists, musicians, spectators, athletes, and collectors. Spread out and find new roads in the all-new Chevy Trax. With 8 different ways to carry gear and friends, make your own tracks and find new roads.
Taking a look now at the CBS6 top picks, Crayola is apologizing after the company's Facebook page was hacked. There were several posts with inappropriate content, especially for young Facebook users. The page has been restored.
All right, time now to spotlight a young student athlete in our area doing their personal best. Tonight, it's a 10-year-old in Glens Falls. And as Kelly O'Donnell tells us, his passion for karate is much more than meets the eye.
All right, ready?
At a junior karate class in Glens Falls, 10-year-old Alex Sorensen sticks out.
Good.
He's the only orange belt wearing a red gi.
He's got an incredible work ethic.
Red means Alex is a member of the Black Belt Junior Leader Club, which makes him a role model for his classmates.
He is regularly leading his own class.
And that's what makes Alex different. Well, that and the fact that he's blind.
So when you're looking at me right now, what do you say?
Nothing, like, can't see anything.
In early 2013, his vision was normal until the day a teacher noticed Alex was struggling to read the board. From there, his vision has deteriorated quickly.
From November to December, it had changed from 2050 to 2200, and his son's gotten worse. So we're waiting on a diagnosis from Boston Children's Hospital, so we're not really sure what caused it.
Alex's peripheral vision is so far unaffected, which means from the side, he can still see just fine. However, looking straight on, Alex can't see a thing.
He's now legally blind, learning to read and write in Braille and using a cane. But giving up karate, that never crossed his mind. He just adapted.
I can hear the people like coming and breathing at me, and I can kind of feel the vibration off of my feet from when they move.
Facing an adversary he can't see, well, that takes courage. But facing this mystery blindness with an unflinchingly positive attitude, that's a whole different kind of bravery.
Because I knew that I would have lots of people with me helping me through my journey.
Obviously, there have been struggles.
The hardest part is not able to read and stuff with all my friends and play lots of different sports with them.
But he's learning new sports like beep ball at Camp Abilities in Saratoga. The family hopes to have a diagnosis soon, maybe within the next couple of months, and maybe what's left of Alex's vision can be saved. Either way, Alex plans on one day earning a black belt.
It just makes me very proud of him. You know, he's a fighter.
Give each other a good bow. Very nice.
For personal best, I'm Kelly O'Donnell, CBS 6 News.
And don't forget, if you know of a student athlete doing his or her personal best, let us know. Just go to CBS6Albany.com and click on the personal best link. We're rooting for Alex now, right?
We certainly are. So inspiring.
Yeah, he's got a great attitude. I'm sure he's going to do good things. All right, the Syracuse basketball team received some very bad news. Details on that just ahead.
Plus, a former NFL running back lives to tell details about his brush with death. Stay tuned. Doug has that and more coming up in sports next.
This week, Billy Gardell, Luke Perry, Peter Facinelli, and Lisa Kudrow get into the new year.
The big dinosaur!
Barney!
No, the real one in Japan!
Oh, Godzilla!
Godzilla is real? With new shows.
He's crazy!
Gary Busey!
Gary Busey is just watching TV.
Oh, come on!
And new laughs.
Part of Greek mythology.
Dumbo?
Craig Ferguson hosts Celebrity Name Game.
This week at 7:30 on CBS 6.
As a wife and mother, I know the value of a great night's sleep. And that starts with finding the right mattress. For more than 40 years, Metro Mattress has helped thousands of people find the perfect mattress. But we want to go even further. Now we're offering you a full year to sleep on the bed you buy from us. If you don't love it, we'll take it back and exchange it for one you will. It's my personal one-year sleep on it guarantee.
You'll love your perfect mattress guaranteed. Metro Mattress.
It's time, folks, for Boatin' RV's 2014 closeout sales event. 3 days only. Savings of 20, 30, 40, and even 50% off selected models. The showroom at Boatin' RV is full of deals. Payments as low as $94.20 a month. No reasonable offers will be refused. Top dollar for your trade-in. 3 days only. Don't miss it. Call 800-BOATNRV. There'll never be a better deal.
$5 million. The New York Mega Millions jackpot is now over $245 million.
Yeah!
2-1. Save huge.
Well, Billy, it's the huge talk event all month long here at Fusilla Ford in East Greenbush, and I cannot say enough about all this selection, especially these Tauruses. How about a 2014 Taurus, only $20,888? Or step up to that SHO Taurus, the show Taurus, all-wheel drive, $27,888. The word is out. It's huge.
CBS 6 Sports with Doug Sherman.
Welcome back, everybody. We told you last week about Rob Conrad, the former NFL fullback who fell from his 36-foot boat while fishing off the Atlantic coast of Florida and then swam 16 hours to safety. Conrad was treated and released at a Palm Beach hospital. The Syracuse graduate lived to tell his harrowing tale, which he did tell today.
I had a wave, an unusually large wave, and I'm not sure if it was from the front that was coming down or if it was from a passing boat, but hit the boat at that point in time, and the combination of the wave and the fish pulling on the rod ejected me from the boat. I did a flip out of the boat. I did not have a personal flotation device on me, and there were no boats in sight. Quickly realized, like I said, I was in a real bad situation, and made the decision that I was going to start swimming towards shore. Talking to the Coast Guard yesterday, I think I was in the water for 16 hours. Like 27 miles. And I shouldn't be here.
Fired on December 29th by the Jets, Rex Ryan today officially signed a five-year deal worth over $27 million to become the new head coach of the Buffalo Bills. The Jets, meanwhile, have interviewed six candidates already for their vacancy. The NBA champion San Antonio Spurs honored today by President Obama for the trip to the White House. The first fan of the sport of basketball praised the sportsmanship of the Spurs as, quote, a great metaphor for what America should be all about.
Let's face it, just a little while back, people were saying that the Spurs were past their prime. Not just old, but kind of boring. Now they're fresh and exciting, which is basically the exact opposite of what happens to presidents. You know, it's a different trajectory.
Well, the college football national championship will be decided tonight between second-ranked Oregon and fourth-ranked Ohio State. Kickoff in Arlington, Texas will be 8:30 Eastern. Syracuse has lost freshman Chris McCullough for the remainder of the season. The 6'10 forward suffered a torn right ACL during yesterday's win over Florida State. McCullough was averaging 9 points, 7 rebounds, and 2 blocked shots per game. Coach Jim Boeheim says sophomore Tyler Roberson will start for McCullough tomorrow against Wake Forest as the Orange look for a 7th straight win. And finally, the Yankees announced today that Gary Tuck will be back in pinstripes this coming summer. The 60-year-old Amsterdam High School graduate, who is now in his 4th go-round with the Yankees organization, will remain as the Major League club's bullpen coach.
Who do you like in the big game, Bucks or Ducks?
Probably the Ducks, but I would prefer to see Ohio State win, for whatever that's worth.
All right, I want them to win, too. And I think they're going to win. We both think they're going to win, right?
Yeah.
You're wearing the colors
tonight.
Yeah,
no coincidence.
Yeah.
No coincidence.
Now, Steve is a Penn State guy, so he's not
right,
happy
yeah,
at all.
I'm just not. You know,
he's like, forget it. My team's not in it. Right.
What's the weather that day?
Normally, Steve is just a ray of sunshine, but tonight, no.
That's it for us here on CBS 6. You can always check us on the smartphone. We'll be back later on tonight.
Good night.
CBS 6 News is sponsored by the New York State Smokers Quit Line. For help quitting, talk to your doctor.
Our wedding day. It's amazing how fast time has flown by. I mean, it seems like just yesterday he dropped down to a knee and proposed. Now we're married. We chose to get married at Riverstone Manor, and I am so glad that we did. Everything was exactly how I wanted it. The staff there is incredibly accommodating, and the food was amazing. If I had to go back and do it all again, I wouldn't change a thing. The Riverstone Manor was just perfect.
I'm looking for something. I'm looking for something.
Awesome.
Very cool.
Casual.
Like me, like me.
It's Raymore and Flanagan's Customer Appreciation Sale.
Pick out the furniture. You've got it in 3 days.
Guaranteed. Featuring our best financing offer.
We did the whole house. Right on budget.
Perfect.
Everything's on sale. 0% interest for 5 years. The Customer Appreciation Sale going on now. Raymore and Flanagan.
Smoking causes some of the most painful and deadly cancers. Quitting is much less painful. You can quit. Talk with your doctor. For more help, call 1-866-NY-QUITS. Smoking causes some of the most painful and deadly cancers. Quitting is much less painful. You can quit. Talk with your doctor. For more help, call 1-866-NY-QUITS.
Tonight, an attack on the U.S. military by hackers. David Martin on the so-called cyber jihad that took down military Twitter and YouTube accounts. The search for an accomplice in the Paris terror attacks. And where was the U.S. at that anti-terror rally? Reports from Holly Williams and Elizabeth Palmer. Dr. John LaPook on an outbreak of measles linked to Disney theme parks. And the President and the Preacher.
Hello?
Yes, Dr. King.
Yes, Mr. President. How are you today?
Michelle Miller on Johnson, King, and the search for the truth about Selma.
This is the CBS Evening News with Scott Pelley.
Good evening. Today, the most powerful military in the world fell victim to hackers. Tonight, the FBI is investigating how they broke into the Twitter and YouTube accounts of the U.S. Central Command, the command that oversees U.S. military operations all across the Middle East, including the war against ISIS. The hackers claim to be working on behalf of that terror organization, and we have more now from National Security Correspondent David Martin at the Pentagon.
The hack lasted about half an hour and no secrets were spilled, but it left the U.S. Central Command with egg on its face. Its social media accounts briefly turned into propaganda platforms for the enemy. Whether by accident or design, the hack occurred just as President Obama was announcing new measures to tighten cybersecurity.
If we're going to be connected,